What's up, guys? Caleb here, and today I am super excited to bring you my first mock in the past, like, at least 2 months, probably, like, since I made a full mock. It's been way too long since I made a full mock, so today I'm going to be showcasing you this huge mock. Basically, I made a collage of seven different scenes from Star Wars that I liked, and they each break apart, and you can basically fix them around with your own collection and just mismatch them around to make different, orders within stuff. The entire mock was basically inspired off the Lego Bricks one, where he did something very similar. We did sort of a clone patrol mock, where he made little bits of scenes of Star Wars and combined them all together, and I really liked that idea, and I decided to do that myself, except I took my own spin on it. The main difference between mine is and his is the epic black back, like, black border that I put around every single one of these that makes it look a lot more, like, professional than most mocks, I would say. Like, really, like, I would highly request to put a black background or border over every mock I make now, because it makes it look so much more professional, and I would request that you guys do too, because it makes it look a lot more professional. Basically, each mock was built, and you can basically just take them off, and that's the same with all these. They just sort of slide into place. That way, I can mismatch them in basically any order I want. Uh-oh, this guy fell off. I can mix around with a bunch of different, like, crazy angles, and we will experiment with those later in the video. And I actually do like how this looks, but this makes it so I can literally just sort of put them at any single position and angle that I want, and that makes it really cool and allows you to get pretty creative with how you structure these sort of things. Off, and also one of my favorites is the Mandalorian one, only because it has this epic Star Wars print that came in the Lego Mosaic set. It actually sits in the bottom corner, and I'm pretty much just adding this to every single Star Wars mock I do, because it makes it look really nice and professional, especially with the black background. They all have the exact same black background that goes around all of them. Basically just shows the Mandalorian from that sort of scene in the trailer, and just him sort of walking around some sort of desert planet with some sand. It's honestly, one of the less exciting ones, but I love how it, just like, puts that classic scene into Lego, especially with the Star Wars logo and the black border around it. We have a Rise of Skywalker one. It's pretty much the scene, I'm pretty sure it's at the end, where they're all, like, fighting on that crashing Star Destroyer. I've always loved that scene. I think it's a really cool scene. And so this is meant to sort of be, like, that area on the Star Destroyer where they're fighting. And I put a Sith Trooper, as it's one of my favorite minifigs I own. I definitely knew I wanted to put a Sith Trooper in there, so we put him in there. Just have, like, a bunch of Greebling and stuff all over the mock. And this one, it just turned out really cool. It's a lot of Greebling, and, it's not immediately recognizable, but I still like it. I have one from my 501st mock series, which I sort of haven't uploaded that many of, but we have Calco Durr and his red coaxium, as well as a sort of, like, little imperial thing with these nice shiny red bricks. Hard to see because I made all of the walls back black, but you can actually see these little studs are actually in a dark blue color, so it is a little bit of a different color and just adds a little bit of detail. It's a pretty decent one from my 501st mock series. I have a mini version of the 501st mini episode, which I entered into Brett Collector YT's mock contest, and I literally just, like, made a scaled down version. It's literally pretty much the exact same thing, but scaled down. Obviously, we have plants, a bunch of vines just crawling everywhere, and we have the Special Forces Trooper that I got at Brick Fair, Virginia this summer, one of my favorite minifigs I own. I knew I had to include this guy in somewhere, and I decided just to make that same scene because I already had a pretty solid mock, and I decided, why not just stick with some of my known? So I built that same mock, basically, but a good bit smaller. By the way, the border for all of these is 10x6 if anybody wants to make their own. Every single one of these is 10x6. We have one not from a specific scene, but just from the planet Mustafar. I'm pretty sure it's called Mustafar, that Anakin gets all burnt up on. One of my favorite Star Wars planets is just, like, this huge lava planet. We have sort of just a battle droid, and it's also got this little platform with controls that's over this little bed of orange lava that I built with a couple orange studs for a little extra detail. Basically just a stand I built that actually sort of pokes out over top of the lava. Obviously, I would make this at a much larger scale if I had more room, but I didn't want to make any of these too tall because it would look really weird if it had a bunch of, height differences. So I had to keep them pretty short and pretty, tiny, sort of like a microfighter. But I do like this one, sort of a Mustafar planet one. We have Zori Bliss's workshop from the Rise of Skywalker, where I'm pretty sure she, like, reprogrammed C-3PO or something. But this is just sort of like a workshop. We have some coins. We actually have some little controls back there. It's a little bit hard to see, and a bunch of weapons and tools she has there. pretty simple build, but you know, I thought it was a cool story. I really like the Zori Bliss minifig, so I knew I wanted to include her in there, and we just made a little workshop for Zori Bliss. Last and possibly my favorite is the one with Finn and Dio from the remains of this Death Star. It's such a cool part of The Rise of Skywalker, where they're exploring the ruins of the crashed Death Star, and I knew I needed to make this on there. He's just standing on this circle platform, and we have him standing there. We have Dio, and we have some of the poking remains of the Death Star that I just love that scene in Star Wars. And I knew I had to get some of that in there, so we actually have got the nice black border and also have this dark inky water. I didn't want to make, like, clear crystal water, because in the movie, it's not like, you know, oh, it's a pretty beach water. It's, you know, dark, gloomy, and, you know, mysterious waters. And so I tried to capture that as best as I could, and I love the color of water. This is probably just my favorite, just because it looks so much like the actual scene. In total, there is 7. Let's see. There's 1, there's 2, there's 3, there's 4, there's 5, there's 6, and there's 7. So, yeah, 7 of these guys. Quite a lot, and I'm going to Thanos snap this back to life. They're back in order, and you know, we can just switch them around in any sort of angle and position that we want to. Make a very large curve, so it just sort of goes around a circle, and you know, if I made 10 or 15 more of these, maybe I could do a giant circle and make some sort of, you know, Death Star design or something cool in the middle. There's down pattern that I had before, which I'm honestly starting to consider leaving it like this, because bruh, it just looks like, man, it just looks so good in this position for some reason. I do like them all straight and lined up, but this just makes them pop out a little more and just look a little bit more unique and interesting, and I don't know, just something about this position I love. Another one of my favorites is the sort of 3x4, where you have 3 at the front and 4 in the back, and that just looks really good for some reason. You know, you can leave them however you want, really. The possibilities are absolutely endless on how you want to display these. Set them up like bowling pins and just use this guy to sort of bowl with them. I don't know. My favorites is the conga line. I just sort of like them all in a clump and cluster like this. A little bit messy, but I also just love the look of it. You guys have it. I'm very, very happy how this little mock thing turned out. I could even see making like 6 or 7 more of these and combining them. I honestly don't even know how I'm going to display them because there's so many options, but I will make a hashtag shorts, you know, talking about how exactly I, you know, put these on my shelves in a day or two here. Which one of your little guys is your favorite? There's 7 of them, and I'm really, really just generally curious which one you guys like best. I honestly really love all of them, but I would be very, very curious to see which one you guys is your favorite. So please leave your favorites in the comments below. The Super Production sign off for now. Make sure to like and subscribe if you want to stay up to date with my latest content. I will see you guys later. Peace.